Hey, I'm Hawkeye. Welcome to Tomboys, Women Going to Extremes. This is my show, a TV series dedicated to women in extreme sports.
Feels kind of good because you're just kind of flying through the air. You're just going. You're just in the air. Well, let's go race, you know, a woodland race, and just for the fun of it on our TTRs, you know, our trail bikes. And we did that just one race, and I said, Dad, I want to race again. And that's just how it started, just from, I think I was, 14, 15 at the time.
Out for practice. She's real smart, real level-headed girl, and so she's, you know, real focused on, you know, playing it safe. She knows of the risk, and so she rides real smart. She doesn't do anything stupid and go over her head, you know, so she's, you know, make sure that everything's ready. There's a, you know, she can do some minor bike maintenance, you know, checks on her bike to make sure that it's ready to go.
It's at Riverdale Raceway, just up in Tootle, and I was just practicing one day, and I was just trying to get over a tabletop, and I made a stupid mistake of not landing with the gas on, because if I did, I probably would have stopped my bike from swapping me. I stayed off my bike for 4 weeks and decided, I think I can get 15th at the qualifier, so I'm going to go and try out. Just, I wanted to do it. I wanted to experience. So, quite a bit, yeah. Halfway through the Washougal series last year, I had a collarbone. My collarbone was working.
I think it was at PIR, actually, and it was a few years ago. I met her on the line at the track. We've been pretty good friends since then, I think.
No, it doesn't matter if it's a woman or a man in the sport of motocross. I mean, it'll literally bring you to your knees.
Congratulatory to her, and just think that's just the neatest thing, that you know, that she's on her roll and prom queen. And one girl got last, another girl got second last, and Brooke ended up beating two of the women on their race bikes, one on a 125 and the other on a 250, on this little trail bike. And so she came in, she goes, Dad, I can run with those girls. My bike's holding me back. The start line was blocks under her feet so she could hold the thing up, and off she went.
Mike kind of is used to it, you know. I mean, she does like going. She likes to be there for all of us when we race, you know.
We even had one girl from California say, well, pretty girls can race motorcycles, too. I remember that comment and just thought, you know, it's really neat.
All these girls lined up, and you're like, how am I going to nail this, you know? It's just a lot of anxiety, but then it's like, you know, right when the guy goes down the line, he's pointing at all of you.
We were at a friend's house on a little practice track, and he said, I can beat Brooke now. I know I can. And Oh, I said, you think so? And yeah, oh, yeah. He goes, two laps, timeless, you know. And so he did it, and then Brooke did it. And, of course, she was like 15, 20 seconds faster.
1973, and just a kid that wanted a mini bike real bad. I saw it, went to the local races up in Castle Rock, and just thought that was the neatest thing in the world. And, man, I wanted to ride motorcycles so bad. And there were some neighborhood kids that had some mini bikes, and you know, rode theirs and just fell in love with it. Just thought it was the neatest thing in the world. And this,
she's been nominated, still do, I think, for a couple of things before, but she's not in the social club. I don't know what you want to call it, this whatever in group. She's pretty shy and quiet and reserved, and we didn't even know she was nominated for the prom. She didn't even tell us.
Anyways, both bikes need quite a bit of
ready this weekend. Welcome to the Columbia River Gorge, gateway to the Pacific Northwest. Hood River, Oregon, home to windsurfing and kiteboarding. Both these sports were invented here. High Mountain Deserts and Mountain Biking on Mount Hood. Across the river, Mount Adams and the Mount Adams Wilderness Area. Kayaking on the Little White Salmon River in White Salmon, Washington. The nationally acclaimed Washougal Motocross Park in Washougal, Washington. Bend in Central Oregon, home to many cycling and stage races. Skiing in the backcountry of Mount Bachelor. Rock climbing in Terrebonne and Smith Rocks. Monkey Face, one of the best rock climbing areas in the country. Year-round snow sports on Mount Hood, the only year-round skiing in the country. Oregon, Washington are home to over 200 BMX and skateboard parks. Mount Bachelor and the Pacific Crest Trail. There are seven mountains in Central Oregon. Oregon's rugged coastline hosts to many ocean kiteboarding, surfing, and jet ski competitions. Tomboys, not your average daddy's little girl. With hundreds of sporting venues in the Pacific Northwest, it holds limitless opportunities to show women in extreme sports as we've never seen them before. By the time we work through the first 100 events, another 100 will be invented and ready to go. Tomboys, Women Going to Extreme, a fantastic show that has great potential for viewers, advertisers, branding, merchandising, and an attractive package for sponsors. Thanks for reviewing this treatment of Tomboys, and I look forward to hearing from you soon.